In this video, I want to show you how you can use Joomla to edit the template files for your website. Now, in Joomla Free, you can make many changes to your website, inserting content, articles, menus, and modules. But sometimes you'll need to go into the code or the template, make some changes to the CSS or other more complex settings. So I'm just going to show you how that works in Joomla Free. In the past, you might have had to use FTP, but nowadays you can do it straight from Joomla itself. So on this website, we've got three templates installed, and our template we're using is called JSN Nuru. Now, go to the templates link here, and you'll be able to select the template you're using. And from here, you'll then get a list of the files of the template, and you can then edit any of the files directly here. Be careful what you do, because doing something wrong can break the template. For example, you can go into the CSS and make some changes to the custom CSS file, and for example, make a change like that, and then you can save and close and so on. So this is a very handy feature. There's one more thing that we should mention, or in just a second. If you need to make changes to the main layout of the site, generally you can do that with the index.php file. And from here you can see the head area of the website, the body area of the website, and so on. And you can add in some code of your own in these areas. But now I want to show you one more advanced feature in this area, and that is the ability to create an override. Now, an override will change the way a component or a module by default is displayed on the website. So let's say you've got a component like a shopping cart, like on this site there's the Hiker Shop shopping cart, and you want to change how it displays the products. You can then make what's called an override, where you'll be changing some of the layout features in a way that will protect the changes you make from being overwritten by future updates to the shopping cart component. So simply select the feature that you need. Perhaps it is the checkout that you want to change, or maybe it is a category view. So let's click on category. Now it tells us it has created the override, and the override is in this folder. Let's go back to the editor and go to HTML, com Hiker Shop, and category. And here are the files. So the listing file contains all the information about how to show this product. And you can then make changes in here, which will then stay on your website even when you do an update to the shopping cart component. So I hope you find this useful, and stay tuned for more updates about how to use Joomla.